It all starts with a dead girl. Ever since I was little, I've had this dream. It's the end of summer. A girl is running through the woods. The moon, the scent of pines. And then the gunshot. It always felt so real. The blood on my cheek, the cold sweat running down my skin. I'd managed to convince myself it really happened, this scar of a memory. A part of me I could never fully understand. Well, that wasn't the only part. No wonder people used to think I was strange. If they only knew. That day when the phone rang, it was the hardest day of my life. The day I went home to say goodbye to my father. Dress him up for his last journey. Put him in a suit, fix his tie. Simple. Just the things he did every day. But looking through his stuff wasn't easy. I needed a moment to pull myself together. I was almost ready. I just had to find his special tie clip. Yeah. Nice to see you too. Looks nourishing. Here you go. What's your face? Glad to see you're still kicking around. I can't believe it's all still here. Oh, Jack. I guess I forgot about this one. I can do it now. Was the last photo I took of you, Jack. Shit. Ah, right. The tie clip. Pull yourself together, Marianne. Interesting. Jack's room. It's like he never... Damn it. Weird to be back in my old room. So many memories. Kids from the orphanage. Not all of them had my luck. That's why I kept coming back. To play. To take care of them. To listen. That was the least I could do. Spirits. There was a time I'd try to run from them. To ignore their calls. Matthew was the first one I helped pass on. I used to get a lot of these. To me, they were like trophies. Badges of honor for doing the right thing. Jack wasn't too amused, but he did his best to cover for me. I kind of feel bad for making him go through all that. My oldest family heirloom. As a kid, I'd show this to people just to freak them out. I'd usually say something like, "Pretty sick, huh?" I was such a dork. Yeah. I used to have a thing for them. Don't know why, really. I guess they just used to make me happy. Jack knew it well. That's why there's so many of them here. Come on, Jack. Where'd you put it? Okay. Let's do this the other way. There you are. Jack was part of the Solidarity movement. He spent a few months in an internment camp, but even that couldn't dampen his spirit. We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers. Jack taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse. Jack's in the prep room. Oh, weird. I don't remember locking it. The key should be in the office. Here it is. Not sure if I'm ready for this. Hey, Jack. Got your special clip. Now, where's your tie? Snazzy. You wouldn't have it any other way. I didn't expect this to be easy. I guess I didn't know what to expect. When things get personal, it just burns you from the inside out. There. I guess you're ready. Am I? Oh, can't you people read? The sign says closed. Oh. What the hell? Guess you felt it too, huh? And then it happened. As it did so many times before. Just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse.
Oh, where is that darn notebook? I'm gonna be late. I need to find that. Marianne? Marianne, are you crying, my child?
It's fine, Jack.
Now, you didn't happen to see my notebook, did you, darling? My memory's a bit fuzzy. So much for aging gracefully, eh? Where is that thing?
Listen, Jack. You should probably get some rest. Forget the notebook.
Oh, no, no. I've got so much work, my dear.
It's okay, Jack.
I can't just... What?
Let it go. It's not important.
You are crying. What's wrong, dear? Why is it so cold in here? Where is that damn notebook?
It's okay, Jack. It's okay.
My sweet little Marianne. What would I ever do without you?
Jack. Don't worry about it. It's time to get some rest.
Oh, Marianne.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm worried about the surgery. When I'm at the hospital, are you sure you're going to be all right?
Yes, Jack. It's going to be fine.
You know, I promised myself once I would never let anything happen to you. Not while I'm around.
I'll be fine. I promise.
risky stuff then. Huh? All right?
All right, Jack. Now, get some rest.
I need... Oh, yes, yes. Be good, Marianne. I love you, my child. I've loved you since the moment you walked into my life. Remember that. Always.
Most people would give anything to have that opportunity. To say all the things that were left unsaid. But it didn't make things any easier. I could help 1,000 souls cross over, but when it came to Jack, it still hurt like hell.
I love you too, Daddy.
I used to think everyone saw the world the way I did. Divided, torn between two realities. But no, I was the only one. Or so I thought.
We're closed. There's another funeral home across town. I can give you the number.
Marianne.
Who is this?
You don't know me, Marianne. But I know you.
Look, if this is a joke...
You need to listen to me, Marianne.
Okay, I'm hanging up.
I know what you are.
What? Who is this?
My name is Thomas. I need your help.
Listen, if that's all you've got, I'm...
No, there's more. I can give you the answers you've been looking for your whole life. But I need you to trust me.
Trust you? I don't even know you.
It all starts with a dead girl.
What did you say?
The Neva Resort. Find me there. Please. The light, it's almost gone. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. You're the only one who can stop it. You're my only chance.
Hello? Hello? Shit.
Thank you.
And off I went, on nothing but a hunch. A call from a complete stranger. But I'd learned to trust my instincts, and there was something about this guy, his voice. I felt like I should know him. Either way, he sure seemed to know me. The Neva Workers Resort. Right off the bat, I could feel there was something off about that place. Anyone home? I guess not. What the? Hello? Thomas? The front gate was locked up tight. I needed to find another way in. You want to keep me out, Neva? They're gonna have to do better than that. Not a whole lot of people knew about Neva. It used to be a government-owned vacation resort. Until one day it just stopped. And so an urban legend was born. The Neva Massacre. The details were always fuzzy. Crazed workers, ancient curses. You know, the usual. Huh. Hello. Huh. What's this old thing here? Oh, what a mess. People can be such bastards sometimes. No wonder history keeps biting us in the ass. Thank you.
What's this? Like an old fort. Might be my way in. The split would come and go. If a place had a story to tell, well, I guess I was there to listen. The place felt old and soaked in misery. Figures, I guess. 1,000 years of history doesn't just happen. It's paid for. But even in the deepest darkness, light can linger. Lonely, fragile, waiting for someone to embrace it. As I absorbed the energy, I wondered who it was that left it behind. A dying soldier whispering the name of his beloved? Or maybe just glad to be done with this war? In any case, I figured I could use it. Energy's energy, right?
Whew. So that worked.
Good for you, Marianne. These powers of mine, as much of a pain in the ass as they were, they did come in handy sometimes. So there I was, existing in two worlds, but never really living in either. To you. What the hell? What the hell are you, Neva? The aura in that place. I've seen others like it, but never this intense. It was like a landfill of memories, emotions. And none of them good.
Definitely something. Trust me.
Yes. It's only a matter of time.
I'm here. No, it's definitely something.
Trust me. You made the right call sending me. Yes. It's only a matter of time.
Even the objects here had auras. When I touched them, I could sense their stories. Words, images, feelings left behind. Hello? Anybody in there? Locked. Obviously. There's gotta be another way. Shit, the handle's missing. Maybe I could replace it with something. Well, I've already proven my prowess as a dumpster climber. Huh? Ah. I think there's a broken window up there. If only I could reach it. I sense something. Hey, old-timer. Now, what's a fine machine like you doing in a place like this? Doubling as a spare bedroom, apparently. Hope you don't mind if I, pop your trunk. Not much here. Although, this could come in handy. Ow! Shit! What the hell? so began the great dumpster heist of 1999. I'm starting to get tired of your shit, Neva. You better be worth it. Hello? Anyone? Thomas? You there? Hello? Thomas?
Easy, Marianne.
It's just a good old-fashioned haunted hotel. Calm your ass down and answer the bell. Thank you.
startled me.
I did, didn't I? You look real scared. I'm sadness.
Marianne. Sadness. Is that your name? I mean, you seem pretty cheerful to me.
Well, it's what I remember. My friends used to call me by a different name. But I don't remember what it was.
Your friends?
Oh, yeah. I used to have a lot of friends here. But they're all gone now.
Did something happen to them?
I don't really want to talk about it.
That's okay. So, do you live here? All by yourself?
Mm-hmm. You wouldn't believe how boring it gets sometimes.
I can imagine. This place must have been...
Oh, yes. So busy. People coming and going all the time. Always someone to play with.
Must have been nice.
It was. Not anymore.
So, tell me, what happened?
I remember. People stopped coming. Only a few of them stayed. But they became very sad. Very angry. They might hurt you.
Thanks. That I can take care of myself. Hey, I was wondering, have you seen...
Marianne?
Yes?
Would you play with me? Just for a little while. It's been so long since I played with anyone.
Oh, okay. But I need your help first.
Yes. Yes! Anything, Marianne!
I'm looking for a man. Thomas. Do you know him?
Let me think. I've heard that name before. Somewhere.
Take your time.
The second floor! We can look there! Come on! Hurry, Marianne!
Wait! I can't go that way! Damn. I need to get up there somehow. Elevator. Might as well see if it works. Sadness. I wished I knew her real name. Shit!
Okay, Marianne, just take a deep breath and... let go.
There, a fuse box. Need some energy to spark it up. Gotta move fast. An out-of-body experience. It's like taking a plunge into nothingness. Stay under for too long and it just pulls you in. Okay, Marianne. Now get your ghostly ass back and power up that elevator. Where did she go? What is that? Okay. Not getting through here. Holy shit! I didn't even know I could do that.
Yes, I'm working on it. Yes, I know. Yes, I understand. Just give me some time. A few days. You'll get what you want.
Ugh, that voice. I don't know why, but it gives me shivers. Looks like the only way. Great.
What the fuck was that?
This room. It feels cold. Memories of grief. Loneliness. An old prescription. I know these drugs all too well. Some objects soak up moments from the past. Just squeeze in the right spot and let it pour out.
Ah, sunflower, weary of time. For my favorite nurse.
Oh, Mr. Tarkovsky, you shouldn't have.
Please, it's the least I can do for all the good work you do around here.
Huh. An actual happy memory. So there's more to this place than just doom and gloom.
Ah, sunflower, weary of time. For my favorite nurse.
Oh, Mr. Tark...
Please.
The spark's too weak to absorb. It's like it's missing something. Disturbingly satisfying. This could be useful. The light of a memory strong enough to defy this place. Now it's strong enough. Manager, huh?
Marianne!
Oh, Sadness. We gotta stop meeting like this.
I told you to follow me!
Take it easy, Sad. This place is huge. It's easy to get lost.
Just stick with me.
Okay. I'll stick like a tick.
You're funny.
This Thomas Rekovich.
What?
All right. Listen, hon. You said you remembered someone named Thomas. Was it Thomas Rekovich? Was he the manager here?
I guess.
You think he stuck around?
I'm not sure. There was an old man here, very recently, I think. Oh.
And you think it was Thomas?
Oh, I don't know. Old men all look the same, all wrinkly and old. Blah.
Hey, that's not very nice. Well, if he's still around, I've got an infestation to report.
Marianne! I feel... Oh, I don't think we should be here.
It's okay, Sadness. Look, there's no one... here. Sadness? It all hit me as soon as I entered the room. Anguish. Fear. Longing. Grand opening, I assume. Hey, is that the first secretary? They must have had some big plans for this place. Someone jotted this down recently. Still works. Someone's been using it. Too small to fit a door. My senses jolted as I touched the phone. I could tell it had been used recently. To call me. The signature. So he designed this whole place? Who are you, Thomas Rekovich?
Old invoices. Outdated documents. Wonder why someone put them out here. I could instantly tell there was more to that clock than met the eye. There we go. That's as far as it goes. There. An imprint. Is that Thomas? Looks like a passage. A spirit well. I could absorb some of that energy. As I moved the clock hand, I realized it was a junction between realities. It's rare, but I'd seen it before. Like I'm in for another dive. Someone tried real hard to keep this place a secret. Wonder what's in here on the other side. Let's see if it worked.
Gotta check the wiring. I'd hate to get stuck in there.
I'll never get used to this. Hope he's not using it as a textbook. Suppressing, huh? Not sure I like the sound of that. I could sense something stirring behind that symbol, like a gust of wind moving a curtain. I hate to think what kind of photos need this much secrecy. Okay, I know how this works. I need three liquids to develop the photo. That's one. Two more to go. This should come in handy. Okay, that's all of them. Looks like there's a tray missing. Shit, I messed it up. Need to dip it in the right order. Shit, I messed it up. Need to dip it in the right order. Too soon. It needs to stay in longer. Who's there? What? What the fuck is this?
Thank you. Please, fuck her.
Hello? Are you all right?
Don't look at me! Don't go!
Oh, God.
Don't leave me here. Alone?
Naked.
Let me draw you off.
Oh, God. No!
Don't worry. You'll just fall. You won't be alone ever again! Everything. It all ends in me!
Not a fan of light, huh? Fucking figures.
Thank you.
Most people spend their whole lives seeing only a fraction of our reality. Lucky them. I have spent my whole life looking beyond the edges of our reality. Even as a child, I saw things that would break a grown man. Eventually, I grew into it. It became my normal. But that thing, it was anything but normal. I've never encountered anything like this. This ravenous. I felt lost. I came to Neva looking for answers, and all I got was more questions. What was that monster? Who was Thomas? And what did he want from me? I woke up with icy water in my veins. I wanted nothing but to get out of there. To just get up and run until my legs give out, until my lungs collapse. But I knew I couldn't. It wouldn't have solved anything. And besides, sadness needed my help. Is someone there?
Mary and Happy. You're okay.
Sadness? Is that you? Are you okay? What was that thing? Hello?
Find Richard.
Richard? No, Sadness. The man I'm looking for is named Thomas. Who's Richard?
The day room.
Day room? Are you trying to show me the way? All right. What now? First Thomas, then Richard. Before I knew it, I was looking for a bunch of strangers. At least Sadness was still with me, in a way.
Cover your nose. Try not to look at him. The sooner we're done, the sooner we can get out of this place.
Ugh. Definitely didn't need to feel that. Locked. Are those bolt cutters? Might be useful. If only I could reach them. Shit! There were some kids here.
Anyone? Ready or not, here I come.
That voice.
I'm sure they're here somewhere. No, Bernard wouldn't do that. He's nice. Ugh, she's talking to herself again. What a freak.
Hey, don't talk about her like that.
Shut up, Bernard. Come on. It's dark in here. This isn't funny.
I really don't think we should.
Shut the heck up, Bernard. Guys!
Oh, kids can be such assholes sometimes. What is it? You want to show me something? What the hell? Snowdrop, huh? Why does that sound familiar? Oh. As I got closer to the mirror, I felt a slight tug in my pocket. I could tell there was more to that figurine than just carved wood. I can feel it calling out to me. It was the first time that had ever happened. I touched the mirror and crossed over to the other side. What the hell is this place? Wait, I know you. You were that boy. Bernard, was it? He was trapped there, just like I was. I knew his name, but somehow that wasn't enough to send him away. It was like a part of him was missing. Figurine was the key. I can't pass through without it. Nothing. Shit! Gotta find something to open the way. Burn, you little fucks. This was yours, wasn't it, Bernard? It's about time you got it back. Sorry you had to go through all this. It's time for you to find peace. Bernard.
Thank you.
It kind of looks like the one I used to get through the mirror. Feels like it, too. No!
I've been where, my little girl. Where is she? Ready or not, here I come!
Travel between worlds. There was no escaping it. Great. Another mirror. Locked. Oh no, there's more of them. What has it done to you? Torn apart. Just like Bernard. No names, no faces, no way to help them. See the other side of this place. Huh. Some sort of a conference room.
I gotta go. The voting's about to start. You know what they say. If you're early, you're on time. No, I mean right now. I can hear them gathering across the hallway. Yeah. I'll let you know how it went.
That voice. That's the guy. An attendance list. I'll bet the name I'm looking for is here on this page. But which one is it?
I can't believe they sat me across from Boris. I don't care whose nephew he is. He's just a sexist pig for all I care. And late, as always.
Some rest. You've earned it, Nicholas.
Thank you, madam.
Okay. One down, one to go. Better get to it.
Details have emerged. The situation may be more complicated than we expected. No time to explain. You'll get the full report once I get back. Just leave it to me, comrade.
Very meticulous of you, comrade. There we go.
mine. It's like a glove. Just let me try you on. Let me eat you up. It won't hurt. Not one bit. I'll eat you up. Just like the others. Oh, my little friends. No more tea parties. Now she's alone. All alone. Sees all this.
I'm getting close. That woman was here.
Oh. She was a ballerina? This room has Guy written all over it. In big sloppy letters. Nice card. Was Vivienne one of your stars?
Okay, last one. I can barely feel my wrist. I don't care. I just want to go to bed. I need to be alone.
Vivienne? Just Vivienne? No. Probably just a stage name. The artist formerly known as Vivienne. There. That's her room. Someone couldn't even let her have her privacy. Okay. Let's find out who you really were, Vivienne. Huh. A page was torn out. I can't make out the numbers. I guess one of these names belongs to your true self. But which one is it? I still don't know her real name. Just words. Sounds without meaning. I still don't know her real name. Just words. Sounds without meaning. Partial numbers. One of these must have meant something to her. A bunch of numbers, some would say. But I sensed there was a lot more to them.
Oh my God, Ellie! I thought you were... No, I'm really happy to hear from you. Why didn't you call sooner? You did? But... Eugene... That slippery son of a bitch.
Ellie. She was very special to her. You don't need to be a medium to see it. So, if you were talking to Ellie, that means...
Tori.
It's you. The real you. That's your name. It made sense, really. A name is more than what everyone calls you. It's what you feel yourself to be.
Hello? Yes, this is Vivian. Room 347. I want to make a complaint. There was a man here. Yes, from the hotel staff. Frankly, I think I smelled vodka on his breath. He... what? That was the chief of staff? You know what? Never mind. Thank you.
Well, it's a stressful job, I guess.
Yes. Yes, Mother, I know. I'm doing my best. What? No, I... well, what about my hard work? It's not always about you. Don't call me Victoria. You know I hate that.
Victoria. That was her given name. But not the real one. Not to her.
Hello? Oh, hey. Are they asleep? It's fine. I know you're busy. I'm busy too. Yeah, it's tomorrow. The big day. Yep. Thanks. I'll see you home. Kiss them for me, okay?
Not exactly a hotbed of passion. This is where it happened. Of all the places.
You? What are you? No! Get out! Ah! No!
No, not pleasant. Not pleasant at all. I'm not gonna lie, it felt good, putting that curse of mine to good use. Moments like that used to keep me going. Now, I'm not sure anymore. You can be free now, Tori.
Thank you. Thank you.
You did it, Marianne. Sent them away. To a better place, I hope. Hell, anywhere is better than here.
Will you just let me pick you up already? Fucking finally. Time to get back to the day room. This place. This is where it started.
Hello, my love. It's your favorite nurse. Are you in there? Even a speck of you left? I hope so. 'Cause I want you to feel everything.
The nurse. It got to her first. But why? I'd never felt darkness like that before. That thing had been there. It was where it made its first kill. Where it tasted death. And liked it. So worth it. I love you, bolt cutters. Kinda sounds like a spy name. Cutters. Bolt cutters. Or a movie star, like in a movie you don't use your real name for. Yeah. Spy name it is. Thank you. Okay, Marianne. Let's see what Sadness wanted me to see. I hope she's all right. Here we go. Thank God.
You're all right. I was so worried.
Oh, yeah. That thing almost got me. What the hell is it?
It came from shame. From helplessness. From rage.
Rage?
It's like anger, but more. Once it got out, we couldn't stop it. It ate all of them, Marianne. All of my friends.
Your friends?
I'm the only one left.
It's okay, Sadness. I'm here now.
No. It'll eat you too. Just like the others.
Shh. I won't let it hurt you. I promise. Here.
Okay.
Hey. Why don't you tell me something about this place?
It's the day room. We used to play here.
With Richard? Is he one of your friends?
No. But he was smart. Maybe he could help you.
He was smart. Wait, is he...
A bad thing happened to him. I remember he became hollow, like a puppet. I remember. Marianne, I don't want to see him.
What? Why not? What do you remember?
No, don't tell them.
Don't tell anyone. You don't have to tell me. But you should still come with me so that I can keep you safe.
No, Marianne.
Sadness?
Never again.
Why did you bring me here? It was then I realized there was something she wanted me to see with my own eyes. Richard? Are you there?
Don't you think he would be better off in a nursing home? What about his family?
Richard doesn't have any family.
Oh. The poor man. It's like he's somewhere else. We were close once, you know. I mean, not that close, but... All right. I'll take care of him.
Hollow like a puppet. Isn't that what Sadness said? Sheet of music. Well, at least part of it.
place is packed with memories. Bad ones. Guilt. Humiliation. Rage. There's a sense of loneliness coming from it. It feels incomplete. Junction. Maybe it can show me a way out of here. The spark's too weak to absorb. It's like it's missing something. Aha!
Come on, Richard. You were always there when I needed you. Let me return the favor.
I don't know, Thomas. What about my work? The university?
Richard, I know they kicked you out. I'm guessing you finally managed to piss off the right people. Stay with us, old friend. Do it for me. For them.
So, he brought him here. Wonder who he meant by them.
That's how you found him?
Yes. He was just lying there.
Mr. Rekovich?
I'm sorry. He was a friend. I just need a moment.
That's not true, Thomas. You thought he deserved it.
Should be all the pieces of the score now.
Richard, my arms are getting tired. You've been drawing me for hours.
Almost done. You know, Lily, you remind me of someone. A girl I knew when I was very young.
Did you love her?
Yes. With a young, innocent love, free of the ferocity of adult lives.
Richard. I'm getting a weird vibe from him. There's grief, sorrow, and something else.
Thank you.
you a bit old to be playing with dolls. Here, I bought it especially for you.
Oh, a ribbon? It's beautiful. Thank you, Uncle Richard.
Here, let me... On the other hand, why don't you do it yourself?
What was that? It's like something stirred inside it.
No! I didn't mean to... Oh, God! What have I done?
It feels... cold. What have you done? I had never felt anything so desperate. It was calling out to me. It wanted to show me something.
King, damn it! Thought I could protect her. Idiot! What would you think of me? I failed you. I failed us. It's all falling apart. What? Yes, I know. No, I need to be sure. There's gotta be something around here. Wait. You want what? Fuck! Look who finally decided to let me out of my cage. And only when you need my help. Surprise. Surprise! Okay, you know what? I'm not in the mood. Just tell me what you see. Come on. Come on! Yes. I can feel it.
Okay.
It's around here. Somewhere.
Oh, well, that's real fucking specific.
Hey, I'm trying to help here.
Well, you know, sometimes I wonder...
Well, it doesn't make it easier when you keep me in the dark for so long.
Oh, Christ.
Thanks for that, by the way. Hell of a way to treat your soulmate.
No. God damn it! There's nothing here!
There is.
Really?
I'm never wrong about these things. You know that.
Well, screw this. I should have known better than to listen to you. Wait. What? There. There. Where? What?
Huh? Oh. Yes. This is it.
Okay.
What? You building tension? Grab the fucking thing!
Would you shut up? He's obsessed. What is it? What have I done?
We couldn't have known.
I let him into my home. You know, he was like a father to me. How could he do this to her? Fucking bastard! Who could he?
I told you we couldn't trust anyone but ourselves. Keep it together. Think. What do we do now?
We wait. And when he comes back? Oh, just...
Whoa. Easy, Tiger. Remember what's at stake here. Just let me do what I do.
You better do it fast. Because if you don't, I will kill him.
Thomas, I wasn't expecting you. Is everything all right, my friend?
Did you do it, friend?
Did I? What?
My daughter. My 13-year-old daughter. I entrusted her to you.
Thomas.
Did you do it?
I don't.
I found the sketchbook. Forced myself to look through it. Cover to cover. Every single fucking page! Tell me you didn't hurt her, Richard.
Thomas, please.
Tell me I'm wrong, Richard. Tell me, and I'll let you go.
It wasn't me. Thomas, you have to understand. There's a sting inside of me.
Shut up.
You have to believe me. I wanted to die.
I'll make it quick.
Thomas... I'm so sorry.
She's my daughter!
I never wanted any of this. I should never have come here.
But you did. Knowing she was here. Knowing what she means to me.
Thomas, I swear. I'll go away. You'll never... Wait. What are you... No! Let me out! Let me out!
Let me in!
cancer has spread far enough. Time to cut it out.